Today, we're going to study about the electronic displacement in organic chemistry. Electronic displacement in organic chemistry, and this is a very important part of organic chemistry which deals with basically the stabilization of organic compounds. So the first is inductive effect. Before knowing that what is inductive effect, one should know that what is a polar bond. Now when we talk about a polar bond, for example, if I'll take carbon, the bond between a carbon and a fluorine, so we know that fluorine is the most electronegative atom. That is why it will try to pull the electron of carbon towards itself, and it will give a partial positive charge to carbon and partial negative charge to fluorine. So always a polar bond is formed between the atoms when there is some difference in the electronegativity. Polar bonds are formed between atoms when there is a difference in electronegativity. Difference in electronegativity. And whenever there is a difference in electronegativity, always the more electronegative atom, it will try to pull the electron closer and it will create a partial negative charge on a more electronegative atom and partial positive charge on less electronegative atom. See, we can also take one more example. For example, carbon, oxygen, hydrogen. Now here the oxygen is more electronegative atom, so oxygen, it will acquire a partial negative charge, whereas the carbon and hydrogen, it will acquire both partial positive charge. So we can also mention here that always the more electronegative, the more electronegative atoms pulls electrons closer, creating a partial negative charge on more electronegative atom. On more electronegative atom. Now why is the polar bonds, they are very important in inductive effect? Because whenever there is any addition reaction, always inductive effect is polarization of shared pair of electrons. That will be towards a more electronegative atom. For example, like when we talk about an inductive effect, So if I take an example of ethane molecule, so ethane molecule is C2H6. So if I write the structure of C2H6, now we can see that there are two electrons of carbon-carbon bond which are centrally located. It means both the carbons have equally hold on this shared pair of electrons. There is no polarization present here. No polarization of electron density is observed here. But as we have seen the above case of COH bond, so there you can see that there is a difference in electronegativity. That is why oxygen acquires a partial negative charge, whereas carbon and hydrogen, they acquires a partial positive charge. Okay, so always whenever there is a polarization, it develops a greater electronegative density on an electronegative atom. Right, it means now the carbon become here electron deficient. Now, when we talk, as I said, the polarization of shared pair of electron towards more electronegative atom is known as inductive effect. What is inductive effect mainly? Polarization of shared pair of electrons towards more electronegative atom. Is known as inductive effect. Right? So, for example, like if there is a carbon chain which is attached with fluorine over here. So, as I have told you that fluorine is a more electronegative atom, so it will try to pull the electrons from carbon atom. And itself it acquires a partial negative charge, whereas the carbon acquires partial positive, double partial positive, triple partial positive, so on. So what you can see here, that fluorine is withdrawing the electron from carbon 1 and making it slightly electron deficient. So that is why in a carbon 1 it will pull the electrons of carbon 2, and carbon 2 will become electron deficient, then again it will pull the carbon from carbon 3. So it is propagated into the entire molecule. So effect is thus propagated into the entire molecule. Now, when we talk about electronegative effects, so there are two types of electronegative effect. One is plus I effect and another is minus I effect. Types of inductive effect. Plus I effect, which is always due to the electron donating group. means whenever to the carbon atom if electron donating groups are attached, then it will cause a plus I effect. So you can say the inductive effect in which the electrons are pushed towards the carbon atom. Plus I effect, it is an effect in which electrons are pushed towards a carbon. And second one is minus I effect, and the minus I effect is due to the electron withdrawing groups. So electron withdrawing group, it means when the atoms or group causing the effect, or when the electrons are withdraw away from the carbon atoms. Effect in which electrons are withdrawn away from carbon. So this can be explained with an example. As suppose I have taken an example CH2, which is linked with N positive NO2, and from the other side it is linked with a alkyl group, or ethyl group. Now we should know that a nitro group, it is an electron withdrawing group. Electron withdrawing group. Whereas the alkyl group is electron donating group. Now when CH3CH2 is electron donating group, so it is giving electron to this CH2, the carbon of CH2, and it will have a plus I effect, whereas NO2, which is an electron withdrawing group, so it will create a minus I effect. So it's taking electron from the carbon atom of CH2. So I'll just give you some common examples of plus I and minus I groups, which are the groups and what is the magnitude of these groups. Plus I effect causing groups are O negative, will be have the greater plus I effect, then COO negative, then CR3 negative, then CH2R, then CH3. Next is minus I effect. Causing groups, so they are N positive R3 will be greater than S positive R2, then N positive H3, then NO2, then SO2R, then cyanide group, then carboxylic group, then halogens, fluorine, chlorine, iodine, then OR group, then at last is OH group. Okay, now here also, see, when we talk about the alkyl group, so among all the alkyl groups, if the number of R groups on a carbon are same, among alkyl groups, if the number of R group on a carbon are same, the larger the size of alkyl group, larger the size of alkyl group, greater will be the magnitude. Greater the magnitude of electron donating inductive effect. Right. Now, next we will discuss about that what are the factors which affect the magnitude of inductive effect. Factors affecting magnitude of inductive effect. So the first is that it depends upon the electronegativity of bonded atoms. So as I have already explained to you, like greater the electronegativity difference, greater will be the magnitude of inductive effect. Electronegativity of bonded atoms. So greater the electronegativity, difference of bonded atoms, greater will be the magnitude. Greater will be the magnitude of inductive effect. See, for example, suppose if I have a chloroethane and fluoroethane, CH3, CH2, fluorine, fluoromethane and CH3, CH2, Cl, fluoromethane. They are on the same position to the carbon atom. But here the more electron deficient carbon atom will be in the fluoroethane, because the magnitude of partially positive charge, it will be more in case of fluoromethane, as fluorine is more electronegative than chlorine. So fluoroethane has the greater magnitude. Fluoroethane has the greater magnitude of partially positive charge than in chloroethane. The second factor, it also depends upon the bond distance from the source. Bond distance from the source. It means that the intensity of the inductive effect, it will decreases as the distance increases. So the intensity of inductive effect it decreases rapidly on increasing the distance. Increasing distance from the source. See, for example, like if we compare the distance between 1, 2, 3, 4 and fluorine and 1, 2, 3, 4 and chlorine. Right, now again in this case the fluorobutane, this is fluorobutane and the below one is chlorobutane. So the positive charge in the fluorobutane will be greater than the positive charge in chlorobutane, again due to the greater electronegativity of fluorine. So you can see the fluorine is partially positive charge, partially negative charge. Chlorine is partially positive, the second carbon is partially positive, whereas chlorine is partially negative, then the carbon atom partially positive, then partial positive. Now in fluoro, when we compare about the fluorobutane, so here if I compare between these two carbon atoms, so the double positive charge on the second carbon atom, it will be smaller than the partial positive charge, the first partial positive charge in the first carbon atom, and that is due to the distance from fluorine. It means the distance of the fluorine of the second carbon atom, it will be smaller than the chlorine with the first carbon atom. Now the important thing about the inductive effect is that always remember, inductive effect operates through sigma bonds. There is no involvement of pi bonds. Inductive effect operates through sigma bonds. Second important point is, like when there is a permanent effect, it always depends upon the permanent property of atom, which is electronegativity. Okay, so inductive effect, this is a permanent effect. The third thing, that always inductive effect is an additive in nature. This is additive in nature. It means, like from the same position, the two groups can cause a strong inductive effect than any single group. It means if I'll take an example, carbon, carbon, fluorine, and if I'll take carbon, carbon, and with the same carbon atom, two chlorine atoms are attached. It means this chlorine is causing minus I effect, I2, and I'll write minus I1. So in this case, minus I1 will be lesser than I2, because there are two chlorine which will be exert more minus I effect, right? And even, but we also know that electronegativity of fluorine is more than electronegativity of chlorine. So minus I effect will be lesser than the 2I effect of the second case, minus I2. It means the electronegativity of fluorine, it is greater than electronegativity of chlorine. Right. So what we have learned about here, that the inductive effect is always between a polarized bond. It means there should be a polarization of shared pair of electrons, and always the shared pair of electrons, it move towards a more electronegative atom. It cannot be occur where there is no polarization or the same electron density is observed. So there will be two types of inductive effect, plus I effect and minus I effect. Plus I effect is always caused by the groups which are electron donating. So if they are electron donating, they will increase the electron density on the carbon atom, which causes plus I effect. Whereas the minus I effect is the effect which is caused by the electron withdrawing group. So the electron will be taken away from the carbon atom or the central carbon atom. So there are different types of groups, and always the electronegativity of the atoms and the bond distance, they both depends upon the magnitude of inductive effect. Now in the next class, we'll learn about what is the applications of inductive effect, how it causes the acidic strength, how we can determine the acidic strength and the basic strength by inductive effect. Thank you.